Watch the Mega Millions drawing live tonight here on TV23. Covering the High Plains with news, weather, and information. From TV23 Studios in Sublette, this is High Plains Today.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the 67th International Pancake Day right here on High Plains Today. We're up early, and I am joined by Lonnie Liljegren and Don Roberts. They are members of the Kansas Pipers. They play the bagpipes, as if you couldn't tell. Guys, thanks for getting up and being here this morning.
You're welcome.
Now, so explain a little of what you're wearing here, because I know, okay, you got a kilt on, but what's the deal in the front? I never understood that.
It's a sporran.
That's where you keep your personal items, your billfold and so forth.
It's your purse.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a guy purse.
Okay.
It's a Scottish man purse. We'll call it that. Okay.
There are already pockets in a kilt, so you have to keep your keys somewhere.
Okay, good. That's a good, important safety tip. Okay, guys, now, Don, we were talking before we went on the air. Now, you've been coming down here since?
1997, okay. Yes.
And you used to bring the McPherson
Youth Pipes and Drums. They were all high school age kids, middle school and high school age kids. And we had a great time coming here to play. And as kids do, they grow up, they graduate high school, they go off to college, then they become businessmen or women, and they have families, and they go away. So now it's me. And Don.
You and Don, you're the lonely Kansas Pipers.
Well, not lonely, but Kansas Pipers, yes.
Okay, so how did you get started playing the bagpipes?
Actually, I'm from Wichita, and I went to the old Cowtown Museum, and there was a pipe band at the time playing. It was about 1986, and there was a band there playing, and they offered to give lessons, and so that's how I got started. And
all right, so how hard, I mean, you see, you actually, when you're playing the bagpipes, you actually blow into the bagpipe and then the music? I mean, how does that work?
Blow into the bag, and from the bag, you're blowing in one orifice, and it comes out four. Three drones and a chanter. So you blow into the reservoir. You have to keep the reservoir tight to make the sound of the chanter and the drones. So you just have a balance of.
So are you constantly blowing in to keep the bag inflated?
Yes, but it's really a matter of coordination to keep the correct amount of air in the bag and make it do the work for you, and to power the drones and the chanter. And
go ahead.
That's really how it works. It's a matter of coordination. Otherwise, you would blow yourself out trying to, you know.
That would be me. I'd be trying to blow too hard. So you're not actually blowing all the time into
it? Not all the time, no. You blow, like Don said, you blow to build up the air in the reservoir, the bag, and then you have to maintain the pressure. And I told you that it goes through, you blow in one orifice and it comes out four. Well, those are impeded by reeds.
Okay.
There are reeds in there, and those reeds vibrate, and that's what makes the sound. But the air passes across the reed.
All right.
So it isn't, it's not like you're blowing in one hole and you're coming out four holes without any kind of resistance.
All right. So, and I asked Don how he got involved in bagpipes. Lonnie, how'd you get involved in bagpipes?
My wife is a McKenzie.
McKenzie clan, right?
McKenzie clan, yes. Clan McKenzie, yes. And we were both school teachers. And we did a musical, Brigadoon, called Brigadoon. We had a piper come there and play for that. And I just got involved that way.
Okay, so when you guys are out playing and stuff and you go to events like this and you've been coming here since 97, what is the biggest thing that people want to hear when you guys are playing the pipes?
Amazing Grace.
Is that what you're going to play today?
Part of it, yes. Yeah.
Okay, what's the other part?
Well, we have a lot of different tunes, the traditional Scottish tunes that we'll play. We'll march in over here in a little bit to a tune called Rowan Tree, which is the tree of love in Scotland. And then we'll play Flower of Scotland, which is presently the Scottish national anthem.
Oh, okay.
And when we play the colors in, we'll play Scotland the Brave, which is not the Scottish national anthem, but a lot of people think it is because that's the one recognizable tune that most everyone knows, that and Amazing Grace.
Well, and it's kind of appropriate, Amazing Grace, since it was written in Olney.
Yes.
So, yeah, that's a good deal.
So that's, we'll play that at the kirking service, too, this afternoon.
Okay, yeah, because you'll be at the Methodist Church after the race and everything playing that.
Right.
All right. Guys, I'm really glad you came by today. The bagpipes are kind of fascinating. I would be one, though. Don says you don't have to blow that hard, but I would probably be blue in the face. But, guys, have a good day today at the Pancake Day. We'll hear you here in a little bit. And it's pretty distinctive when you hear them coming on. So, thanks, guys.
We certainly thank you for the invitation. All of these years, we thank you for the invitation.
So. Well, we're glad you're here.
It's fun.
All right, stick around. We'll be back with more after this.
Feel connected, informed, included, inspired. So when important things happen, we're here. Your local TV and radio broadcasters. America's number one source for news, weather, and information on every screen in your life. We are broadcasters, always here for you, wherever here may be. Text TV to 52886. Tell Washington local stations matter.
Kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Something I feel when I'm right here.
Separate raw meats from other foods by using different cutting boards. 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
And welcome back. We're at the 67th International Pancake Day. I'm now joined by Marvin Billings. He is with the Liberal Kiwanis Club. He is... I'm going to call him Mr. Griddle, but you're the director of the kitchen or something, right?
Yeah, that's right. That's what we're calling it anyway.
For lack of anything else, you're like the head dishwasher, cooker, get the griddles ready.
Chief cook and bottle washer.
Okay. All right. So now with this new griddle, now you guys, the Kiwanis Club, are in charge of cooking all the pancakes and the sausage.
That's correct.
So... with the new griddle, now, what time did you get here this morning to start this, baby?
I got here at 4:15.
And you lit the fires?
Yes, I did. Got the griddles up and oiled up and ready to cook.
How long does it take for that thing to heat up?
It takes about an hour.
Really?
Yes.
So what all is in, I mean, to get it ready to go, I mean, you were actually out here yesterday and had it fired up for a little while, right?
Well, I was here both Saturday and Sunday. And we set it up and got the stuff on the floor and all that kind of stuff. Then Sunday we came out and cleaned the grills and wiped them down, oiled them all up and got them prepped for cooking.
So you get them all, now do you heat them up to clean them?
Oh yes, yes.
And then you kind of put some oil on them to get them seasoned?
Well, you want to sterilize them.
Okay.
You got to remember they spend the summer in the barn.
Okay. All right. So, but now this is a new griddle that you guys have, and it has how many cookers? I mean, there's what, 6-8 people over there now?
There's 8 grills to this, all temperature controlled grills.
And it runs off propane, right?
It runs off propane. It's quite an engineered deal. We can do all kinds of things with propane, and the way we set it up, we could run it off your home propane bottle if we wanted to.
That wouldn't last very long.
No, it won't last very long, but we can do it.
What are those little ones like for your grill? It'd be gone pretty quick, wouldn't
it? Oh, yeah. Yeah, sure would. We have 2 150-gallon tanks sitting outside.
And you're starting to cook a bunch of pancakes. The line's starting to build up. They started serving pancakes at 6 o'clock this morning, and there's been pretty much a steady stream of people in and out.
Yeah, yeah. A little slow getting started this year from what we're used to, but now it's picked up. It's about steady.
So when they start cooking the pancakes, now do you know how much batter they go through when they're doing all this?
We have 400 pounds of dry batter. That's just the dry, and then, of course, we mix it up and stuff.
400 pounds?
400 pounds.
That's a lot of batter. That's a lot of bags.
That's a lot of bags of batter, yep.
Okay, sure. So and then sausage, of course, you got two guys down there on the end cooking sausage. There's, how much sausage?
There's 2,800 pieces of sausage.
That's a lot of sausage.
Yeah, that's a lot of sausage. There's 90 gallons of orange juice. There's be about 300 gallons of coffee when they're done. I don't know how much butter because we switched to the little packets this year.
So. I saw that.
Yeah, it's a little different for us.
So when do they start mixing up the pancake batter? I mean, you've been out here Saturday, Sunday, and yesterday getting the grill ready and everything going.
After I fired the grill this morning and started heating them and all that, I started mixing batter.
Okay. So now what do you mix with the batter? Is there milk in it? Is there water? What's in it?
It's a complete mix. So we just mix water with it and stuff. And then we have an industrial mixer that we stir it with.
Oh, you got a big one that goes around.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So okay.
We can get after the mix into the batter.
All right. So now, and is the batter donated?
No, we had to buy it this year.
Okay. All right. So, but the Kiwanis Club, I mean, you guys have this grill now. And now this isn't the only place that you use this, right?
No. We've used it in all kinds of different community events and stuff. And they used it down at Guymon for Pioneer Days and things like that.
And you kind of engineered this baby, didn't you?
Yes, I was in on the ground floor of engineering this thing.
Because before, we had
2x3 pieces of sheet steel with a edge welded around it with 2 3/4-inch pipes underneath, holes drilled in it for burners.
And it wasn't very portable.
Oh, no. You had to tear it down and reassemble it every time you moved it.
That's a lot of work. That's a lot of work. So, okay. But, and this one burns much cleaner too, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we don't have near the smoke and all that. The temperatures stay even, being it's thermostatically controlled and stuff.
Okay. 400 pounds of pancake batter.
Yep. That's the dry batter.
And how much sausage?
2,800 pieces.
So, okay. And now the sausage, where do you get sausage?
Sausage comes from Seaboard.
Okay, that's good. Well, that's nice of them to provide the sausage.
Yeah.
And the orange juice is?
Orange juice came from Dillon's this year.
Okay, and then Prairie Fire is here with the coffee.
Coffee.
Always good coffee from Prairie Fire.
I used to make it years ago. Nobody complained.
Okay, so when you had to make it years ago, how many coffee pots did you have to use?
Never used coffee pots.
Okay, how did
I used 15-gallon stock pots. That I brought the water to a boil, and then I poured in instant coffee and stirred it around and looked at it to see. It looked about right.
And kind of like back in the old days around the campfire with the cowboys, you'd throw in a horseshoe, and if it floated, it was ready.
Yeah, yeah. And considering I don't drink coffee.
So who knew then,
yeah,
right?
You got it.
Okay. All right. Marvin? Thanks for taking the time to kind of explain the big griddle to us, because that has been a vast improvement. And thanks for coming by today and sharing. 400 pounds of pancake batter, 2,200 sausage patties. How many gallons of orange juice?
90 gallons of orange juice.
And a ton of coffee.
Coffee.
That's a lot. That's a lot. But you're going to feed a lot of people out here, and the line's picking up, and you can hear the bagpipers are getting ready. So, anyway, we'll be back with more after this. Hi, I'm Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs at noon weekdays right here on TV23. Hey, do you think you have an idea for something that would make a great segment? Somebody that would make a great interview? What about a community event that needs highlighting? Let us know here at the station. Email us, news@kdgltv.com. Hi, Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs weekdays at noon right here on TV23. We talk about news, we talk about sports, we talk about weather, we're even going to talk entertainment. We'll have live guests right here on set with me. So, every day at noon, tune in, High Plains Today. We'll see you then.
Weekdays here on TV23.
Yes, sir. Can I hold my stuff? Is that
okay? All right, Dan, welcome back to the 67th International Pancake Day celebration right here at the Seward County Activity Center. As you can hear, the bagpipers in the background are getting warmed up and ready for the breakfast program. It's going to start here in about 10 minutes or so, and we'll be covering that live. But right now, joining me is one of the stalwarts of International Pancake Day, Mr. Mark Strange. And if you are from Liberal, you're going to know who this guy is. How are you today?
Good. How are you doing, Chris?
So far, I'm okay, but it's early.
Great.
There's a lot of day left.
A lot of day left.
Okay, so Mark, you've been involved with Pancake Day for, since I can remember.
This is my 39th year on the board. Next year is 40, so it'll be my big anniversary.
That doesn't mean anything. Well, that's true. Okay, so you have done about everything there is to do on the pancake board?
Pretty close, and this year is really unique because we've got our chairman, Rhonda Stump, we've never had a situation like this. She is terribly sick.
She has like a respiratory virus going around or something.
Exactly, and she has literally been ordered to bed. So Jack Jacob and myself and Gary Clausen, those of us that have done things in the past are just splitting it up and filling in today and making it work.
Well, you're all past pancake chairman, so you kind of know what's involved.
Right. So it in that respect, it's great. We have a lot of people that can fill in, can come in and take over, back up when we need to. So things will go right on like seamlessly today.
I'm sure it will. All right, so for those people out there who have never been to a Pancake Day, and yes, I know there are some that are out there, and today is the big day where the race versus Olney is being held. Now, you've been to Olney, right?
I've been to Olney, yes.
Okay, so What goes on over in Olney during the day?
You know, Olney's celebration is much more laid back, much smaller, really, than ours. Theirs is purely a half a day event, and starts that morning. Lots of planning goes into it, but it starts that morning. They have breakfast. They have fun things in the market square. But basically, the whole day is centered around the race and the shriving service.
Well, they only been doing it once since 1445.
They've got a year or two of experience. Yeah.
Okay, so for those people, now let's do a little history on Pancake Day, and how it got started in Olney, and then how it came over and got originated here in Liberal.
Okay, back in the legend goes.
Legend.
The legend goes that. It was Shrove Tuesday, and people used their they made pancakes to use up the ingredients that they couldn't use during Lent. Their cooking
the
oils,
yeah, right. Fat Tuesday.
Absolutely. So so the lady was making pancakes and heard the church bell ringing. She was late for the shriving service, so she took off running toward the church, skillet in hand, pancake in skillet. And was flipping it along the way and got to the church steps, and the verger gave her a kiss.
Now, what's a verger?
A verger is in the bell ringer, essentially,
okay.
In the church over there.
Verger, bell ringer.
I hope if that's not right, someone can correct me. But anyhow.
Send those cards and letters and emails to Mark Strange.
So that's how the tradition was born. And then in 1950, R.J. Leet saw an article in Time, I think it was Time Magazine, about the ladies of Olney, England and their pancake race. And he was president of JC's here looking for a fundraising idea. Thought it was a great idea, so he challenged the ladies over there, sent a challenge to the vicar, challenged the ladies of Olney, England to a race. And 67 years later, he could never have dreamed that it would still be going on. And we're just thrilled that it is still going on, going strong.
And the Kansas Pipers, amazingly, are playing Amazing Grace, which was written in Olney.
Absolutely. John Newton was from Olney, wrote Amazing Grace. John Cowper actually wrote the words, and John Newton put it to music. And both of them from Olney. I've actually been to the cemetery, seen where those gentlemen are buried. It was a pretty amazing experience.
So now the course here in Liberal pretty much mirrors the course in Olney, correct?
Yeah, the course in Olney is a little more of a lazy S, not quite as, the turns aren't quite as sharp, but it does go uphill toward the church. So, you know, I think when you even it all out,
it's going to be kind of hard finding it uphill to the church here.
It's hard to find uphill to anything here.
I guess we could take them down on Highway 54 to the Cimarron River and make them run uphill.
There you go. But yeah, the lazy S is, so our courses pretty well mirror each other. Yeah, they're pretty close.
So, and the race consists of, it starts at 11:55, because that's back in the day when the bells were ringing in Olney for the shriving service, correct?
Exactly, yeah. 11:55 is the international race every year. That's, that is when the race, that's the official time when the race is run. And we go from the end of the race then right on to the Methodist Church for the shriving service.
For the kiss of peace.
Kiss of peace is going to be actually on the steps of the church. We're trying to get a lot of those traditions back a little closer to the way they used to be done. So this year we don't have a representative from Olney, so our mayor, I believe, is going to do the kiss of peace on the church steps on the way into the Methodist Church. And then we'll go in for our shriving service.
Okay, so the activities are getting ready to start here this morning. The breakfast program is going to start here at 7:30.
Yes.
And then after that, you know, you can still, what, come get pancakes till, what, 10 o'clock?
Absolutely. And then we have children's races.
Start at, what, 10:30
yes,
today?
Yes, 10:30. And then the men's pacer race will be at 11:45, leading up to the big international race at 11:55.
So, okay, so the pacers, the men's pacer race, the way it got started way back in the day was those guys when it was nice and cold. But it's going to be good today. We're talking about, what, going to be in the 60s, probably upper 40s, lower 50s by race
right.
time. But when it was, like, really cold and the women had their coats and stuff, the men's pacer race was, for those guys, to carry the coats to the finish line for the women racers, right?
Right. That is exactly right. They carried the coats so that when the women got to the finish line, then they could put their coats on, stay warm, and so we don't do the coat thing anymore. But
no, now it's just a flat out race. Best man wins.
That's
on pace
right.
Race, isn't it?
That's right.
Yeah. If I started the pace race, I don't know about you, but I would finish maybe tomorrow.
And we have some really fun competition this year. I don't even want to think about doing the pace race. I don't even want to walk that course.
But I don't want to do the kids races, Mark.
But we do have some fun competition going in the men's pacer race this year. We've got a group of five construction guys that are here building the new high school.
Yes.
Not the high school.
The new bond issue, yes.
And so, you know, that's what we like. We like to run for fun. We've tried to promote that idea, get a little competition going for even the international race. It's not so much about having to win it. It's just having fun with it.
Yeah, and it's the competition between, you know, Liberal Kansas and Olney Ingham because, you know, they're two drastically different towns.
Right, completely different type of communities. They are so laid back compared to, in every sense, compared to the way we operate. But the people over there are wonderful. I've made lifelong friends over there, and I hope to return one of these days. Just got to get time to get back over there.
Well, you're going to just have to make time.
I know.
You and Laura, just load her up, get on a plane next year, and go to Olney.
We've actually talked about a little group of us, if we can spring loose sometime. Tim Fowler, Tim and
yes.
Arla, and Laura and I.
Tim Fowler's another one that's been on the Pancake Committee about as long as you.
Yeah, he's right behind me. He is. But they've been also, and we'd love to go see all of our friends again, and it is nice now we do our video chat so we can actually see them rather than having to just do the phone
call.
Yeah,
and that all happens at the United Methodist Church. After the shriving service, they'll have the international phone call where Liberal and Olney will compare times to see who the winner is.
Right, and you can actually just stay and play in your seat and witness the whole thing.
That's kind of a cool deal.
Yeah.
And then the kids' races are going to start after the breakfast at 10:30 this morning. If you want to see some fun, I mean, the little kids run about 50 yards. It's kind of fun to watch them, especially because you got three-year-olds and up are running, boys
right.
and girls. So that's a lot of fun.
It is fun. And it's fun to watch them have a good time with
yeah.
them.
Yeah. Mark, thanks for taking the time.
You bet. Thank
you are like one of my – he's my go-to guy on everything Pancake. Thanks for coming by today. Well, I'm sure I'm going to see you the rest of the day, too. All right. Stick around. Be back with more.
Same time next week?
Well, of course. Put away a few bucks, feel like a million bucks. For free tips to help you save, go to Feed the Pig.
Foods to the right temperature using a food thermometer. 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
At this time, our bagpipers are going to play Flowers of Scotland. They're from McPherson, Kansas. Let's welcome our bagpipers this morning. Is presented by the Liberal Police Department. Thank you to the Redskin Singers for leading us in God Save the Queen and the Star-Spangled Banner. Would you join me as we pledge allegiance to our flag? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And we'll ask the Reverend Arlen Ankle, the pastor at First Church of the Nazarene, to lead our invocation.
As we pray today, we want to remember Ronna Stump, who I understand is under the weather and unable to be with us. Let's pray. Our loving Heavenly Father, we bow before you with gratitude in our hearts for your blessings upon us. We thank you for this special day in the history and of our city and that of Old England. We recognize the efforts that have made this event what it is today. And Father, as we pray for safety for the participants and spectators as well. Use the food, the good of our bodies, enable us all to have a wonderful day. We pray these favors in Christ's name and for his sake. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Allow me to welcome you to the 67th International Pancake Day Breakfast Program. My name is Jack Jacob. I am not Ronna Stump. Rana is our general chairman, and as far as we know, for the first time in the history of Pancake Day, something took out the chairman. So you got Plan B. Pancake Day is always a fun event that has grown to become an amazing unifier of our community. As you look around, even around this room right now, there are people with light skin, people with dark skin, people that speak different languages, people that are from different socioeconomic levels, and it doesn't matter because this day we come together as liberal and we want to welcome you this morning. We do have some special guests with us, and let's just say before we move on to recognizing some of our dignitaries that each one of you is our special guest as we make up this community. But there are some folks that are on my list that have made some effort to come and be with us here today, and we want to both recognize them and hear from them. First of all, from U.S. Senator Jerry Moran's office, we have his better half, Robert Moran, to come and bring you greetings.
I'm not from his office, I'm from his house. My name is Robba Moran, and I bring greetings from Jerry, who is in Washington, D.C. today, and I think it's snowing there. I told him that liberal is kind of like Palm Springs of Kansas. I think you're supposed to have 70 degrees tomorrow, so that's great. I'm glad to be back. I think this is my fourth or fifth Pancake Day, and it's just one of the greatest events for a community in our state. Jerry and I have traveled around the state for many years and gone to lots and lots of community events. And I think Liberals Pancake Day is, if not the best, one of the best. So you have a lot to be proud of. Yes, you should thank yourself. You have a very diverse community, and you do a great job of bringing everyone together at different events, including this one. So I wish you all well today, and to finish out your weekend, I also would wish luck to the American women as they race and flip their pancakes at noon today. So have a great weekend, and thank you for allowing me to join you.
We also have here today, although we will not necessarily hear from him, but we certainly wanted to recognize from Congressman Huelskamp's office, John Beard is with us today. So John, if you're in the building, would you please stand? John is probably busy visiting with folks as he did last night and does each time he comes. We would like to, at this time, recognize our Senator, Garrett Love.
Well, good morning. It is great to be in Liberal. It's great to be at, I guess, my sixth Pancake Day. I haven't missed since I've been in the Senate. It's one of my favorite events of the year. And it's an honor to be able to serve you in the Senate. To work for you in Topeka. My little baby girl, Abby, she came last year for her first Pancake Day, and I was talking to Jan about she's ready to run in it, I think, but she got sick this morning or yesterday, and so she's not gonna be able to be here. But it is great to be with you guys. I had the chance to serve as a chair of the Ag Committee, and fighting for agriculture, fighting for Southwest Kansas, fighting for Highway 54 are all priorities of mine, and I appreciate the opportunity to serve. And we are moving into another presidential election season, and want to leave you with a quote. It says, "All that is necessary for the triumph of evil is for good men and women to do nothing." That's by Edmund Burke. And just a good reminder to stay involved, stay engaged, because it is your government. And just like I am your senator, I'm elected to work for you. Sometimes elected officials start to look at themselves like they're kings when really we're servants. It's our job to serve. But thank you again for the opportunity and the responsibility to do that. And it is great to be with you today.
And just to make sure I get this right, from Congressman Shannon Francis's home, right, Robba? And office, we have his wife, Carol Feather Francis.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity to say a few words for Shannon. He wanted to be here, of course, today with you to celebrate Pancake Day. But the House of Representatives is scheduled to debate the budget tomorrow, and he has to be in Topeka. Well, let me say that first, Pancake Day and this breakfast have a special place in our hearts. Some of our earliest memories of this breakfast and Pancake Day. It is proof that we're a strong community with strong traditions. And I want to thank you for the faith and trust that you've placed in Shannon to represent us in the state legislature. He takes his responsibilities very seriously. This is our home, and we want our kids to have the same opportunities to be successful like we've had. He's working hard to make sure we have great schools and great roads and many opportunities to succeed. With that, we wanted to say let's all do our best, meet Olney, of course, and have a great day. But there's a secret. That is what we wanted to say. And who knows if I'll ever get to do this kind of fun thing again. So I'm jacking the podium. Don't tell him. Don't tell anybody. What I wanted to say is, what a privilege. What a privilege to be married to now Representative Francis for almost 30 years. What a privilege to get to be the one to see best how hard he works. To get to be the one who knows how much he studies and learns and discusses and listens. To get to witness the sacrifice he makes to serve us. And this is a good one. To get to know his true heart for fiscal conservatism and good government. Now, the fiscal conservatism, honestly, sometimes at home, I yearn for a little fiscal liberalness. You know, it's like, can we just get a new toaster? But it's true. It's true to his core. What a privilege to get to know how much he constantly cares about doing his very best in representing the 125th District. But thank each one of you, really, because without you, I wouldn't have this privilege.
We are also privileged to have the mayor of Liberal with us, Joe DeNoyer.
I don't know how much of a privilege that really is, but anyway, good morning. First of all, on behalf of my fellow city commissioners, I would like to take this opportunity to welcome the dignitaries that have made their way here or their representatives from their offices. And also, I would like to welcome all of you for coming out for the 67th Annual Pancake Day, and then of course all of the groups, organizations that have come together to make this event possible. You all give of your time, your talents, and of course sometime your finances to put on this event. Most do so seeking no recognition and often would prefer to stay out of the limelight, but now at this time I would like each one of you, if you have been involved in Pancake Day at all, whether it was this year or in the past, to please stand, because without your undying dedication to this event, we would not be having Pancake Day for 67 years. So if you've been involved in Pancake Day, let's give them a round of applause. Thank you, thank you, and thank you. In 2015, the city of Liberal has seen a lot of progress. But we still have a long way to go. We have seen job growth and we've seen job decline. While most are enjoying $1.34 gas, let me remind you that are jobs, those are families, and that's economies that's affecting. My hope is that we as a community reach out as friends and neighbors and lift each other up and continue to be the giving, caring community that we know we are to those who are hurting right now because of cheap gas prices and for other reasons. First of all those experiencing difficulty times, I offer my thoughts, prayers, and hopes for a brighter future. Just today, as we see organizations coming together to make Pancake Day an event that has stood the test of time, we too as a community must work together to make Liberal the best city that we can. We must set aside our differences, we have to put away the negativity, and we have to think and work positively. We need to come together to work as one. We cannot sit idle just waiting for things to happen. We must meet the challenges head on and make those things happen, but we must also meet the challenges that we have imposed on ourselves. Just as you ask us as governing bodies to come together, the city, the county, the school board, the hospital, the college, we ask that you too come together to work with us. As Senator Love said, we work for you, and we need you involved in every step of the way. We also need to continue to strive and work diligently to break down the barriers that are holding us back. We have to step out of our comfort zones and go beyond our self-imposed barriers. We need to get to know each other once again and work as one, because we are one community with one goal, and that is to continue to make Liberal the best city that it can be and make it a great place to live, work, shop, educate, and raise a family. My hope is for each and every one of you to look at each other as an integral member of this community, draw from each other's strengths, build each other's weaknesses up, and come together, and we will become that great city. We're here together. This is our town, so let's make it something that we all can be proud of. I also hope for continued support of the community on projects from quality of life amenities, economic development plans, our comprehensive park plans, street improvement projects, housing projects, and of course our new schools. Most of all, I am grateful for you for the continued support of the 1 cent, 1.5 cent sales tax. Without this, none of these projects would be possible. Folks, Liberal is our home. I personally wouldn't live anywhere else. You know, when I'm out and about in Topeka or wherever, and they ask me what makes Liberal so special, I could probably come up with a million reasons. But look around you. Look at each and every one of you. It is you, the citizens of Liberal, that make us the community that we are. We know what we're capable of when we unite. We've seen how we can come together as a community, whether it's in support of a 7-year-old boy fighting cancer, workers injured in a fire, or in supporting a family after a tragic accident on a baseball diamond. We here in Liberal stand as one. Today, my challenge to you is to make a difference. Together, let's make 2016 count. Thank you, and God bless Liberal, and go Liberal race winners. Thank you.
Thank you. I struggle to call you Mayor DeNoyer because we know each other so well, but that is proper. Thank you, Mayor DeNoyer. At this time, we'd also like to present to you, if you did not have the opportunity to come out for the Miss Liberal Scholarship Pageant, first of all, shame on you. But second of all, you missed a treat, because I would like you to meet Miss Kansas 2015, Hannah Wagner, someone who gets what she wants.
He said it best. I wanted pancakes, and I'm on pancake number 7. Anyone else? Normally in the morning, it takes me a while to get up, but this morning, I swear to you, I smelled pancakes, and I have gotten up faster than I ever have in my life. To run here today and flip some pancakes, I don't know, did anyone see me flipping pancakes over there? I'm glad that's not my job, because it didn't end well. I am so honored to be here. Thank you for having Miss Kansas out every year. I know this is a staple for the Liberal community, and it means so much to the state of Kansas and that you would have me out here today to embrace this day and embrace these awesome pancakes. Truly means a lot to me. I'm very excited to share this with the new Miss Liberal. Look at her. Congratulations. She is one amazing woman, and I hope you get to know her. As she'll be, are you racing today? All right, we're racing today. She's definitely going to outrun me. I usually only run if someone's chasing me, so this is going to be a little different for me today. But thank you for having me out here, and if there's anything that I can do to help you all make this day even greater, come find me. I don't think I'll be that hard to spot. Thank you all, and enjoy the pancakes, and welcome the new Miss Liberal.
In just a few seconds from the time that she said, the only time she runs is when someone's chasing her, I've already gotten 12 text messages from volunteers. You heard her mention 2016 Miss Liberal, Gabby Amperon. Gabby, come and share with the folks. Folks, give it up. This is our Miss Liberal.
Good morning. I'm very happy to be here. This is actually my first year at the Pancake Day breakfast, but I think it's awesome to see such a diverse community come together on this day every year. It's a lot of fun. I used to race in it growing up, and I'm looking forward to racing again. I hope I don't embarrass myself. I'm a little out of shape, actually. But I look forward to a wonderful year, and it was just a privilege to be crowned Miss Liberal. I'm excited to represent the community that I love, and just happy Pancake Day. Thank you.
We are blessed to have all of these guests. We also have some other guests that we want to recognize. If you are here, would you please stand when you hear your name called? We have our five-state fair queen, Jordan Urban, here with us. We also have some city commissioners here with us. If you're from the city, would you please, city commission, would you please stand? And then we have some county commissioners with us. If you're a county commissioner, would you please stand? I believe that makes a complete set, so thank you for being here. Well, Pancake Day would not happen if it were not for a group of people that live, eat, and sleep Pancake Day throughout the rest of the year. Most of you wake up on this day and think, I can't wait, like Hannah said, I can't wait to go down and eat some pancakes and get involved and watch the races. But there are a group of people that meet together year-round to make plans to make this possible, and we would like to recognize them at this time. This is our Pancake Day board, and we would like to have you stand and be recognized. If you would, hold your applause until all of the board members have had an opportunity to stand. First of all, our ad sales this year was done by Shannon Whetstone. So thank you for that, Shannon. Our Baby Cakes Award coordinator is Jan Nondorf. The breakfast coordinator is Greg Bird. And if it's like most of the time, he's probably run around somewhere crazy. Oh, he's over there this time. I looked left last time, and what? Yeah. Anyway. Ronna Stump is our chairman this year. She is she's in charge of the dignitary hosts. Tony Smith is in charge of our dignitary reception. David Ryan takes care of our eating and flipping contest. Mark Strange is our Hall of Fame representative, because he probably is there. The inter-school competition is taken care of by Gary Clausen and Alicia Bird. Gary's in the merchandise trailer, and Alicia is down here. Gary also takes care of merchandise. The Miss Liberal pageant is headed up by Carrie Smith. The parade by Mike Brock. The postal cancellation by Jan Nondorf. Publicity, Janice Northerns. The races by Ronna Stump and Rick Potts. The race prizes by Amy Eichele. Security by Patsy Gwynn. The shriving service by Keith Engelmeyer. The talent show by Sally Fuller. Social Media by Heather Williams, and the webmaster is, well, me. Our photographer is Chris Linenbroker. That is your Pancake Day board. Would you please recognize them all with a round of applause? I would also just like to tell you that if any time on our website, on social media, in the paper, and other places, as you encounter photographs that you appreciate, you do have the opportunity to purchase those if you will see Chris Linenbroker about that. We'd also like to say, in addition to all of these, a big thank you to a bunch of groups of people that make this Pancake Day celebration possible and fun. It starts on Friday, flipping into schools, and it ends with an international web chat. Actually, it ends with us sharing the stories and laughing about all the things that we had the opportunity to witness throughout the rest of today. But there are a group of folks, several groups of folks, that need to be recognized. For instance, we have the Lions Club, the Kiwanis Club, the Police Department, the Fire Department, the Parks and Rec Department. Did you notice a common denominator? We could say the City of Liberal, really, couldn't we? We have Ryan's Karate. We have the Miss Liberal Board. We have so many groups of people. Let's take the opportunity, and if I miss someone, just come and yell at me. That's what they do at church. So let's just give a round of applause to all those groups that come together to make this possible. And at this time, we would like to introduce our international race contestants. They are located to my right. If you would stand when you hear your name called, if you would hold your applause until we've had the opportunity to recognize all 11 plus a few honorary racers. First of all, we have Nakisha Cohens, Leslie Spikes, Shauna Quint, Ashley Workmeister, Kitty Lum, Abby Hubbard, Summer Parsons, Johnette Johnson, Sally Yates, who's over working on taking tickets, she's our treasurer, Jerisha Benoit, and Lindsay Kloss. Those are our international racers. Now we have some honorary racers as well. We have Miss Kansas, Hannah Wagner, who will be racing. She just gave me the high sign to say she's really excited about that. 2016's Miss Liberal, Gabby Amperon, will be racing. And Tessie Barnett, who has raced 12 times, will be running with us this year. So how about a big hand for all of our international racers? This time we'd also like to introduce you to our men's pacer racers. Again, if you would stand when your name is called, and if you would hold your applause until they have all been recognized. We have Tyson McGuire, Randy Ortiz, Irving Altamirano, Robert Pino Hildreth, Lee Moore, Connor Villanueva, Joe Grassmuck, Chris Orellana, Brandon Buck, Matt Quint, Matthew McLean, Matthew Williams, Fernando Zavala, Tyson Small, and the second baseman for the San Francisco Giants, Kelby Tomlinson. Thank you, men's pacer racers. At this time, we have some awards that we would like to give out. Every year, we recognize an award called the Hall of Fame Award. It is given to an organization that has been particularly supportive of Pancake Day over the years and deserves special recognition. This year's Hall of Fame Award goes to the Liberal Convention and Visitors Board. Mr. Jay Bakta is going to come and receive that award on behalf of the Liberal Convention and Visitors Board. Thank you very much.
Good morning, everybody. Just wanted to say thank you, and thank you for the opportunity to serve you guys, and look forward to the whole day of the races and all that. Thanks again.
It's always nice to have the prerogative as an MC to set the mic where you want it. I don't need a step stool this time, but everybody else has to hunker down. Next, we have the RJ Lead Award. The RJ Lead Award is named for a great community person that helped to get Pancake Day started, really kind of had the vision and let that spread to others. A longtime Pancake Day supporter and liberal citizen. And this award goes to people who, a person or people who kind of represent that same ideal. That stand for, live for, breathe, bleed Pancake Day. And our recipients this year are Greg and Alicia Bird. Greg Bird, this is the part where you drop the box and you come walking this way. You can meet him halfway, right, Alicia? He's like, you're interrupting my work. Which is what you're recognizing me for, so what's up with that?
Get over here. Wow, this caught me speechless, which is very hard to do. So, this is I was up here last year and stuff, so thank you guys very much for this award. Just Pancake Day, we both kind of live and breathe it. I was born into it, so I don't really know what to say. It's wonderful to be involved in a community that comes together to have something fun like this. So, kind of with our fellow people across the water. So thank you very much.
Thank you much.
A man of many words.
Do you find it interesting that people say, in the middle of a speech, you've made me speechless? At this time, we would like to recognize the Grand Marshal of our parade. Now, I have to tell you a little story about Al Shank Jr., who was our Grand Marshal. He said when he found out that he was going to be the Grand Marshal and he would not be announcing the parade, he said, it's not rocket science. They hand you a notebook and you read what's there. I have three complaints. There was no notebook. There was no reading. And I still can't figure it out, so it must be rocket science. How about let's recognize Al Shank Jr., our Grand Marshal of our parade. Al, come up and be recognized.
So yesterday I asked, I said, do I need to go to the breakfast tomorrow? And I was told, well, yeah. I said, do I have to say anything? And I was told, no. That didn't work out too well. I appreciate the opportunity to do this, and I appreciate anything I can share with my father, who was the Pancake Day chair and a once upon a time, or the Pancake Day announcer for the parade and the races. Passed away in 1988. I think Dad and I have been fortunate enough to do that all but maybe 3 or 4 years of the whole event. But anything that I can share with Al Shank Sr., gentleman that he was, is something that really touches my heart. So I thank you for this award. Most of us, if we've lost our parents, we think about them daily, and even if we haven't, we think about them daily. But I always think, especially on this day, Pancake Day, about my father. So I appreciate everybody. This is a great community event, wonderful community event. You know, one of the things that happens is when you're in liberal Kansas, we have some of the most creative people, like RJ and Virginia Lee, like people who said, you know, they say Dorothy's house in Kansas, but they never really said where, so why not liberal Kansas? So we have creative people who do great things, and it's always great just to be a part of it and watch the competitors. The day will be no different. So thank you very much.
Just to be clear, when you end up with the B team, mistakes are made. When I was recognizing the board, I forgot to mention that Sally Yates is our treasurer. I tried to plug that in with the racers. And Tim Fowler is the coordinator of all things Pancake, including flags and arrangements and storing things in his garage and representing us in Wichita and just all kinds of other things. So Tim Fowler, sorry for that oversight. At this time, we would also like to make a special recognition for someone deeply connected to Pancake Day who is unable to be with us here today. The name Donna, or most people know her as Joan Zimmerman Collison, passed away August 6th, 2015. A major claim to fame in her life is that in 1952, she was the first U.S. winner of the International Pancake Race, the challenge race between us and only England. She was the first U.S. winner and set the world record time and carried that as an accomplishment that she bragged about, and then her family even bragged about in her obituary, recognizing her death. And so we'd like to say, I know there's none of her family here with us today, but we want to recognize her. Would you take just a moment with me to be silent so we can remember that contribution? Thank you. Thank you. There are many people that have been involved with this race. I mean, you can't do something 67 years without it touching many, many lives. And so thank you for that opportunity to recognize her. Well, the breakfast is almost over. At least the program is almost over. You can continue eating pancakes until 10 o'clock, or if you're like me at the buffet, until they ask you to leave. We will move on from that to the rest of today's activities. We'll move on to the youth races at 10:30, the men's pacer race at 11:40, the international race at 11:55, the shriving service at 12:15, and the live video conference at 1:15. Let me just throw an encouragement in there for you. If you have never stuck around for the international web chat and viewed that, it is much different than the old days of the international phone call. You actually get to see what happens and can hear kind of the banter back and forth and really get a sense of, yes, this is a competition, but it's also something that unites us. I asked our friends from Only England last year on the web chat if they wanted their colonies back. They asked if they could become one of ours. So it's a good time to give each other a hard time, but a great time. So if you've never been a part of that, let me encourage you to do that. Also, don't miss the Kiss of Peace will be given to the international race winner, or the liberal leg of the international race winner, at the steps to the First United Methodist Church. And so if you would like that photo opportunity, you can join them there at the steps to the church. Our mayor, Joe DeNoyer, will be on hand to offer that Kiss of Peace. At this time, I'd like to ask you to rise as our fire department retires the colors.
This concludes our breakfast program, but before we go, I just want to check one thing. How many of you think Liberal is going to win this year? Thanks, come out and cheer on our racers.
And welcome back, there you have it. 67th annual International Pancake Day breakfast and program. Now you can still get pancakes up until 10 o'clock. This is just the meat of the program and stuff is over. All the dignitaries, all the awards have been handed out. Now we're gonna move downtown. Youth races start at 10:30. We're gonna dive down there and shoot some footage for you of all the races and maybe a couple of interviews so that we can bring all the highlights of Pancake Day to you tomorrow on High Plains Today. We'll be back on the air at noon tomorrow at our regular time. But in the meantime, thanks for joining us today. Hope you have a great Fat Tuesday, and we'll see you all tomorrow right here on High Plains Today.
Up to date with the latest information from TV23 on our Facebook page, KDGL TV.
You want to feel connected, informed, included, inspired. So when important things happen, we're here. Your local TV and radio broadcasters. America's number one source for news, weather, and information on every screen in your life. We are broadcasters, always here for you, wherever here may be. Text TV to 52886. Tell Washington local stations matter.
Two outs with a runner on first and one. Now the big guy comes up to bat, hitting 342 with 92 RBIs and 36 home runs. This is our 50,000
Chill raw and prepared foods promptly. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
There's something I feel when I'm right here.
Same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. For free tips to help you save, go to
Feed the Pig.